Hi learners, welcome to ICT-based SEU program. Today we are going to discuss our first module, listening and speaking skills. Dear learner, like many other skills, listening is a skill. As a child, you listen to people around you and that's how you learn to speak. There are four language skills: listening, speaking, reading and writing. So you can see listening precedes speaking. But unfortunately, listening is a forgotten and neglected skill. For many students, listening is the most difficult skill to acquire. Now I will explain various aspects of listening, but remember, to improve listening, you have to make some efforts. What do we really understand by listening? Real listening is an active process which has three components, namely hearing, understanding, and judging. Let's discuss them one by one. First, hearing. Hearing just means listening enough to catch what the speaker is saying. For example, say you were listening to a report on zebras and the speaker mentioned that no two are alike. If you can repeat the fact, then you have heard what has been said. Understanding. The next part of listening happens when you take what you have heard and understand in your own way. For example, take the report on zebras. When you hear that no two are alike, think about what that might mean. You might think maybe the pattern of stripes is different for each zebra. Judging. After you have heard what the speaker has said, think about whether it makes any sense. Do you believe what has been said? You might think, how could the stripes be different for each zebra? But then again, the fingerprints are different for every person. I think this seems believable. Listening techniques. To improve your listening skills, you should understand and apply some of the skills which I am now going to discuss. Establish an agreeable atmosphere. Be prepared to hear the speaker on his own terms. Be prepared on the subject to be discussed. Avoid getting mentally sidetracked. Listen for and summarize basic ideas. Understand the speaker's organizational pattern. Whenever possible, take notes. Establish an agreeable atmosphere. Listening needs concentration. Before you start listening, make sure you have the right environment to facilitate your listening. This means you should try to avoid noise coming from outside, like sound from a music system, an electric motor. Be prepared to hear the speaker on his own terms. You can't possibly have any control over the speaker. It is you who should try to accept the speaker's way of speaking, the voice, the volume, or the pitch. You should also make allowances for the speaker's circumstances. Be prepared on the subject to be discussed. Listening is always better if you have already prepared on the subject you are going to listen to. You need some mental warm-up. Before you see a serial drama, there is always a recap of the previous installment. This helps you to connect. Avoid getting mentally sidetracked. You should also try to avoid internal distractions of all kinds. If you are worried or depressed, chances are you wouldn't listen properly. Listen for and summarize for basic ideas. Try to listen in a way that you can summarize the whole thing at the end of the listening session. If you can restate the substance of what you have heard, you have done a good job. understand the speaker's organizational pattern. A good speaker always organizes his speech. If you can understand his pattern, it will greatly help you to understand his speech. Whenever possible, take notes. Since it's not easy to remember what you have heard, you should rather take quick notes without disturbing the listening process. Dear learner, now I'm going to give you some tips for being a good listener. Give your full attention. Don't look out the window or at anything else going on in the room. Make sure that your mind is focused too. If you think you know exactly what the speaker is going to say next, you are wrong. If you find your mind wandering, change the position of your body and concentrate on what the speaker is saying. Let the speaker finish before you start talking. Speakers don't like to be interrupted. When you interrupt, it looks like you are not listening. Let yourself finish listening before you start talking. If you are busy thinking about what to speak next, probably you can't be a good listener. Listen for main ideas. The main ideas are the most important points the speaker wants to get across. The main points are normally given at the start or end of a talk and repeated a number of times. Pay special attention to statements that begin with phrases such as "my point is" or "the point to remember is." Ask questions. If you are not sure you understand what the speaker has said, just ask. It's a good idea to restate in your own words what you have heard so that you know that your understanding is correct. For example, you might say, when you said that the two zebras are not alike, did you mean that the stripes are different on each one? Give feedback. Sit up straight and look directly at the speaker. Now and then, nod to show that you understand. At appropriate moments, you might also smile, frown, laugh, or be silent. These are all ways to let the speaker know that you are listening. Remember, you listen with your face and also with your ears. Think fast. Remember, thoughts move about 4 times as fast as speech. With practice, you can simultaneously listen and at the same time think about what you are hearing, understand it, and give feedback to the speaker. Dear learner, here are some more points to remember. Don't worry if you don't understand all you hear. You don't need to understand everything you hear. Listening is a process of selecting what is relevant to your reasons of listening. Keep listening to radio or television, even if you don't understand everything. Enjoy yourself. Listening to a foreign language is like reading a detective story. You read a few words and phrases and piece them together intelligently to get the full message, rather like a detective solving a crime. Before you listen to any broadcast, it's a good idea to try to predict some of what you are going to listen. If you are tuned in to expect particular information, you are more likely to hear it and understand it. Speakers always stress important information. If you can recognize this, you will be able to understand him and not worry for each and every word that you hear. When people speak, they often repeat what they have said or say it in a different fashion. This helps the listener because they get one more chance to hear the same information. Making intelligent guesses is an important part of successful listening. You have to pick up clues as you go on listening. If you are listening to a news, remember, a news has a structure. First, the headlines, meaning the main stories at the beginning. Second, the details, meaning the stories in details. And finally, the main points again, meaning the summary of the whole stories at the end. If you are careful, you can listen to the news much better. Dear learner, so long we had been discussing what is listening, what are the skills of listening, and how to improve your listening skills. Remember, listening as a skill can be improved only by practice. In the next segment, we'll be discussing speaking skills. Dear learner, we have already discussed what is listening. As a listener, you tend to imitate the speaker around you. When you speak, you copy the style of people around you. Since your mother tongue is acquired, you can't ignore the linguistic influence of other speakers around you. The same is true for learning a second language. Like listening, speaking also involves some skills. It's important that you are able to speak clearly so that people can understand you. Now I am going to discuss how you can improve your English pronunciation and speaking skills. First of all, don't worry for not having an English accent. It's almost impossible to speak like an English speaker. However, you can do many things to improve your speaking skills. Listen to spoken English as often as possible. Learn the phonetic alphabet. Don't forget to learn the word stress of a new word. Work out which sounds cause you most problems in English. Be aware of intonation and sentence stress. Changing stress. Intonation. Don't rush. Listen to spoken words in English. Listen how people speak various words and phrases and model your pronunciation on what you hear. Listen to BBC regularly or any other favorite program in English. Learn the phonetic alphabet. Most good dictionaries have a phonetic alphabet page. Use that as a guide to pronounce new words. Don't forget to learn the word stress of a new word. Every English word has its own stress. This means that a syllable of a word will be longer, louder, and high-pitched than the rest. For example, the word believe has two syllables, be and leave, but only the second syllable is stressed. We say believe and not believe. Your dictionary will show the syllable stress by an apostrophe before the syllable to be stressed. Word stress is very important. In fact, it's more likely that someone misunderstands you because of a wrong word stress than because of wrong pronunciation of a word. Work out which sounds cause you most problems in English. Our mother tongue, Bangla, shares some of its sounds with English, but there are uncommon sounds as well. For example, there is no long vowel sounds in Bangla, but in English, you have to differentiate between fill and feel, full and fool to make your meaning clear. Be aware of intonation and sentence stress. Not all words in a sentence have equal stress, and generally, the information words such as nouns and verbs are stressed. Look at the following examples. Where's the pen I gave you? Where's the red pen I gave you? Where's the red and blue pen I gave you yesterday? The unstressed words such as the, I, and don't carry as much weight as the stressed words. They are almost smaller in length and at times abbreviated. For example, and becomes an. Sentence stress isn't fixed like word stress. In fact, you can stress on words that are normally unstressed to highlight different meanings. For example, when you say, I love you, you mean you love and just not like the person. Again, when you say, I love you, you indicate that you and not anybody else who loves that person. And then again, when you say, I love you, it means that it's you and nobody else. Intonation. There are a couple of easy ways to remember the rules of intonation. Usually our voices go up at the end of a sentence to show a question and down at the end of a sentence to show a statement. Don't rush. If you speak too fast, you might skip over some words, fail to pronounce them completely or mix them up. If you speak slowly, you might sound unnatural. In fact, it's always better to speak slowly and clearly rather than too quickly. Dear learner, now I will give you some tips to improve your speaking skills so that you can communicate easily and effectively. Practice where you can, when you can. It's important to build your confidence. Try to experiment with English you know. Try to respond to what people say to you. Try not to translate, forgetting a word. Try to relax when you speak. Practice where you can, when you can. Any practice is good, whether you are speaking to someone who is a native English speaker or not. It's important to build your confidence. Try to use simple English sentence structure that you know to be correct so that you can concentrate on getting your message across. Try to experiment with the English you know. Use words and phrases you know in new situations. The native speakers are more likely to correct you if you use the wrong word than you use the wrong grammar. Experimenting with the vocabulary is the best way to improve your speaking skills. Try to respond to what people say to you. Sometimes you can get the clues of what people think of you by looking at their body language. Respond to them in a natural way. Try not to translate into and from your own language. This takes more time and will make you more hesitant. Forgetting a word. If you forget a word, do what the native speakers do all the time and say things to fill the conversation. This is better than keeping completely silent. Try using if you forget a word. Try to relax when you speak. You will find that your mouth does most of the pronunciation work for you. If you are speaking at normal speed, you will discover that most of these speaking skills, like linking of words, happens automatically. Dear learner, here we come to the end of our discussion on listening and speaking skills. Remember, listen more and more to improve your listening skills. And don't be shy to speak. The more you do it, the more confident you will become. Thank you for being with me.